glad to see you made such a speedy recovery.
What is your problem?
Me? You who just pulled the stupidest stunt of all time wants to know what's the matter with me?
Spare me,
Brenda. Ned, what in the world would make you think that you can get away with something so totally outrageous? What am I saying? Obviously, nothing is too extreme for you these days. Ned, why did you have to make it so obvious?
I wasn't faking.
Right.
You really think that I would trash a $100,000 car for the sake of a stunt?
Are you really asking me that with a straight face?
Good morning. I hope you both slept well.
Good morning.
Oh, look. Cook's made some of Annabelle's very favorite sausages. Oh, no, wait a minute, dear. Just a moment. And only one. We can't spoil you. Oh, Ned, the last time that we spoke, you were going to try a new approach with Lois. Tell me, did dishonesty work? Ned and I had a very interesting discussion the other day about the advisability of using dishonest methods to further honest pursuits.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
You are completely and utterly hopeless.
I gather it didn't go as well as you hoped.
Let's just say there were a few bumps in the road.
You got yourself a date. Only if Ashton definitely knows about it.
I think that could be arranged. As a matter of fact, that could prove to be the second most appealing part of the evening.
Lo, come on, we're going to be late. AJ, we are running a business here, you know. There's no soliciting, there's no harassing the management. What are you doing here?
I'll see you later.
Later. Bye.
I'll see you later? What's up with that?
Oh, nothing to worry about. What's up?
What's up? We're supposed to be at the Outback telling Miguel about Puerto Rico.
Oh,
remember?
Shit.
Remember?
Right, right. I got wrapped up in things here.
Well, unwrap yourself and let's go.
Yeah. You know what? Would you go get the car for me, please? I just have one more little phone call I gotta make.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Hurry up.
Okay.
Back home to Puerto Rico?
That's right, all expenses paid. For your own concert. I love it. You leave town on the run, you return a star.
And Lily did all this.
Well, she reminded us that all those teeny boppers whose hearts throbbed for you a few years ago, they're grown-ups now, with money to spend, hopefully on CDs. I mean, we stand to make a monster profit.
And the only question is, where do we throw this party?
Yeah.
We need a concert set.
Mm-hmm.
I'll think about it.
Oh, yeah, why don't you and Lily go put your heads together?
It sounds like big plans.
Yep, this is going to put L&B on the map.
Yeah. Max, can I use your phone?
Help yourself.
Wait. You know, once Miguel hits the big in Puerto Rico, we can take him anywhere. We'll be international.
I knew I should have put money into your company when I had the chance.
Well, it's never too late. Which reminds me, oh yeah, I've got to go meet Sonny. So why don't you think about it, man?
Yeah.
Maybe I will.
Good to hear your voice too, okay?
Sonny.
What?
Everything's falling apart.
What is?
L&B.
Not possible. I won't let it happen.
Yes, sis. There's nothing we can do about it. I mean, you and I are just like pawn standing on the sidelines watching the whole thing unravel, and it's just completely beyond our control.
Aren't you being a little melodramatic?
No, I'm talking about Lois and Ned, and there's no such thing as being melodramatic.
So they're fighting. My bet is they'll get over it.
No, it's beyond that. Lois is never going to forgive Ned, and you know what?
What?
He doesn't even deserve to be forgiven.
Why is that?
Because when it comes to Lois, Ned Ashton is like the dumbest man on the face of the earth. I mean, if there's some decision to be made, you can bet that Ned's going to make the wrong one. You know, I just think he can't help himself.
Brenda, tell me what happened. It can't be that bad. Nothing's irreparable. So, you're telling me he pushed it into the woods and smashed in the windshield?
Not funny.
Yeah, you're right, you're right. There's no way to trade a Ferrari.
This is serious. He involved the paramedics and the hospital. I mean, the point is, he's trying to manipulate Lois again.
Well, that works both ways. I mean, don't you think Lois is doing her version of the same game?
No.
No?
No.
Sure she is. I mean, her lips are saying no, 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 but her eyes are saying yes, yes, yes.
Well, oh, I can't believe you just said that. That is so totally sexist.
Come on, Brenda. You know that's how those two operate.
You know, if you have some warped idea, then Lois is actually enjoying this. This is not a game to her, Sonny. I mean, you've seen how furious she is.
Yeah, which tells me she still cares. If she didn't get mad, then we'd have a problem. But passion, I can work with.
You think so?
Sure, those two have feelings to burn. They're just going 100 miles an hour. We just got to get them towards each other instead of the opposite direction.
Yeah, well, it's not exactly that simple.
Whatever we do, we can't get caught at it. We don't want to turn Cirilla into the human volcano and be back to square one.
Okay. So whatever we do, we have to do it right away, Sonny, because I cannot handle this guilt any longer.
Lois already forgave you.
Honey, you know that as long as Lois is in pain, I am not going to sleep at night.
Oh, that's right. You, need your beauty rest.
Don't make fun of me right now.
Okay, look. I want to wrap this up as quickly as you do, but until those two get past these emotional distractions, I am seeing dollar signs zoom by.
So what do you think we should do?
Think, my darling. Use your imagination.
Honey, I've been thinking, but everything I come up with just seems like more manipulation.
Huh? At least Miguel and Lily are behaving.
Yeah, they're really beautiful together, aren't they?
Their money in the bank. So work on this. How do we get Ned and Lois to be more like Miguel and Lily? Listen, basically all we had to do is get the two of them together, get out of the way, and let the magic happen.
Yeah, well, it's true that ever since Lily got here, Miguel's been on cloud nine, but do you know that he hasn't written a lick of music? I mean, he may be happy, but he's not singing about it.
Miguel's CD is done. It'll be in the store soon. He doesn't have to start cranking out number two yet. Let him enjoy himself. Let him soak up life experience so he can write about it later.
Are you sure?
Listen, Lily had a great idea about taking Miguel to Puerto Rico. That concert would be the ticket to get him back to composing. In fact, this lady's presence is going to make our Mr. Merez one happy and productive dude.
Well, you sure think a lot of her, don't you?
Well, she knows, you know, what her man needs. She knows what he wants.
Well, maybe that's because her man talks to her.
What is that supposed to mean? Are you saying you don't know enough about me?
I'm just saying that maybe we could figure out more ways to communicate if you would just open up a little bit.
I told you where I learned to drive. I told you about my hardcore friends. You saw me bleeding on the ground, for crying out loud. What the hell else do you want to know? Who my first girlfriend was?
Sonny, hello, I'm trying to find ways for us to share more. I'm trying to find some way for us to get close.
You're trying to find ways to make me more like Miguel. Ain't gonna happen. You know, I'm getting a little tired of being compared to him anyway.
No, wait. Okay, listen. You just right now said that the reason why they get along so well is because Lily knows him. Well, how do you think that happened?
She's very observant.
Oh, give me a break.
You don't want to know. You don't want to know who I was. Okay? You wouldn't like him. It's taken a lot of hard work to become who I am. And frankly, I'd rather you pay more attention to me. Is that okay?
Who's some manufactured guy that doesn't even have anything to do with the real Sonny?
I am the real Sonny. There's no... It's as real as I can get.
Oh, well, if that's supposed to comfort me, it doesn't.
Well, how come you can't be happy with what you see? Why do you have to be so damn interested in what I left behind years ago?
Okay.
Every time.
Listen. It's because I feel alone. Okay? Every time I try and talk to you, it's like I can't get past the main gate. You send out messages with the butler. And when do I get to know the guy who lives in there, Sonny? I don't even know your real name.
Jimmy Hoffa. Al Capone. Gandhi. The Fifth Beatle. Popeye the Sailor Man.
It's after business hours.
I need to talk business.
Oh, just make yourself at home.
Good. Got a seltzer?
What do you want?
Hey, Brenda.
Oh.
You're wet.
This better be good.
I don't want to see your face until you've worked things out with Lois.
Is this my face?
Uh-huh.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay.
You've made up?
I'm here because I want to honor my contract with L&B Records. I'm ready to get back to work.
Well, what does that mean? You want us to broker a negotiation between you and, Lois?
The hell with Lois. I want you to set me up a concert.
Huh? Thank you. What brought about this change of heart?
Lois and I have a verbal agreement. And I intend to honor it.
And what exactly are you prepared to do?
Sing, perform, tour, record, whatever.
Promote?
It won't work unless we go all the way. I want to sit down and plan a promotional concert as soon as possible.
As Ned Ashton?
If L&B thinks that's the best.
You're not concerned about the backlash from the quartermain?
I'll handle them.
Sorry, Ned, it just takes a minute to sink in.
I'll spell it out for you. I want you to do whatever it takes to make my singing career a success. Use me, abuse me, throw me on a tour bus or a talk show, whatever. Let's just make it happen.
Oh, wait, I get this. This is the courtship of Lois Cirillo, chapter 25.
What does that mean?
You dog, you plan to exploit Lois's weakness for music to get her back, right?
I am tired of waiting around. I want to get back to work. And that's what I do best. Besides, I miss the singing.
Right, and you miss Lois. And you think this is how you're going to get her back. And I agree with you. It's actually brilliant.
Think she'll go for it?
Wait, this is a scam?
Well, if questioned, I'll deny it. But sure, I have nothing else to try. I'm desperate.
And now you're using your brain. I mean, this will just be our little secret.
And the part about wanting to sing again, that's the truth. And will you help me?
We'll sell you harder than you've ever been sold before.
Yes!
Thanks. Listen. You won't regret this. I'm out of here.
Lois is putty. We're in the money. We're in the money.